here it is saying a total number of 20 patients admitted to a hospital having blood sugar level is given. So here it is given to your total patient, that is 20, that are admitted in the hospital, and each patient is having this much sugar level. Okay, you have to prepare the frequency table here. So I told you for preparing frequency distribution table, I will write down the class interval. Okay, and for class for finding out the frequency, if I prepare the tally marks, so I will easily get the frequency. Okay, so here 3 points I have written. First one is the class interval, tally marks, and third is the frequency. Class interval means, suppose here it is given 67, 69, 74, 73, this much it is given, huh? 71, 69 is all of you. If I will write down 69, 64, 65, so it will become too lengthy. So I am preparing class interval here. Okay, so I will do the grouping method. So if I write down class interval from 65 to 70, okay, if I write down class interval from 65 to 70, okay, then 70 to 75, okay, and from 75 to 80. So I can easily find within this three group, I can write down the, I can prepare the frequencies table from here. Okay, so see, class interval 65 to 70 means 65 to 70, the patient who are having the sugar level. So let's find out how many patients are having sugar level from 65 to 70. So first is 67. 67 will come under this. So 67 and 14, 110 mark. Again 69. Yes, 69 will come under 65 to 70. So one more tally mark. Then 74. 74 will fall between 70 to 75. So 74 here I will put. Okay. 73. 72. 75. Then 70. So see, 270s are given, na? So here you will write down from 65 to 69 and here from 70. So this is 70 to 75, so you will put down one mark here. So one more 70 is there, so one tally mark here. Then 71, this is also for 70 and 71, so you will cancel this. Now 67, it will come here. 73 will come here. 74 here. 73 here, 75, so here you will come, 69, here, 72, this will fall here, okay, now 70, 270s are there, so 1, 270, 72, 70, okay, then 73, then 74, okay. From here, if you can see, this is 1, 2, 3. 3 tally marks means number of frequencies 3. Here you can see, this is 5, this is 5. Okay. So, where I have committed this type of? So this is the, in this way you have to prepare the frequency distribution table here. Number 3, as I am not having space to write in the blackboard, I am reading the question from the book. People see the question from the book. So here, what is given? Question number 3, it is saying, the weight in kgs of 30 students of a class are given. So what is given to you? Weight of study, 30 students in a class, and then weights are given, student class. Well, suppose one student is having 50 weights, another is having 49. This type of weights is given of a particular student. So how many total students are there? 30 students are there. Okay. So these weights are given. You have to prepare a frequency table for the above data and answer the following question. So what you have to prepare? Frequency table you have to prepare. Frequency table means you know how to prepare first. Weight you have weights, what how many weights are given? 41, 42, 43. Regarding this, you prepare this weight. And then with this, suppose 41 student, how many student, 41 is the weight, how many student it is having 41 weight. So with the help of telemarks, you can find out the number of student who has having 41 weights. And when you prepare this frequency distribution table, I told you from this, suppose 42, from here you can see 42 means 2 student you will get. So 2 student telemarks, so frequency will be 2. Similarly 43, 1 student telemark, so frequency is 1. That means 41, 43 is the weight of the student and only 1 student is there under this. Okay. So in this we prepared the frequency table. Now what questions you have to find out? What is the least weight? Least weight means less. Okay. So from here if you see 41 is the least weight. Okay. So from here what is the least weight? You can write down answer. 41 is the least weight here. Okay. Now the next question is, find the number of students having the least weight in the above data. Now what you have to say, the number of students you have to find who is having least weight. You know as the least weight is how much? 41. So what is the number of student here who is having 41 weight? That is 1. So as you know, the least weight is equal to how much? 41. And only one student is there who is having the weight 41. Okay. Next question is, find the number of students having the maximum weight in the above data. Maximum weight means max to max weight you have to find out. So for maximum least means 41. Maximum is 57. 57 you can see. Two telemarks means 2. So how many student, what it is asking, find the number of student having maximum weight in the above data. So maximum weight is 57 and only 2 student is having. So answer will be, maximum weight is 57 and 2 student is having this weight. Okay. Now what is the next question? Which weight do the maximum number of student have? Now you have to find out the maximum number of students. Maximum means more, means you have 7. So this is the maximum number of students. So which weight this it is having? Maximum number of students is having 50. This is for 54. 57. So maximum weight is, maximum number of students is 7. And the weight it is how much? 50. So in this way, first you have to prepare the frequency table and then you have to find out the following question given in your textbook. Question number 4, read the question from the book. It is given, the value of pi up to 50 places, 50 decimal places given. Means the value of pi, you know value of pi is 3.14. This is given up to how much? 50 places, okay? In this way, write the frequency of the following digit in the decimal part of the above number. So find out the, we have to find out the frequency of the digits. For finding out the frequency of the digit, first we have to prepare the frequency distribution table. So write down the digits, okay? With the help of the digit, prepare the telemarks, and after preparing the telemarks, we will get the digit frequency here. So here it is the digit frequency. So first question here it is, Write the frequency of the digit in the decimal part of the above number for 2. Okay, for 2. For 2, you have to write out the frequency. For 2, if you see the frequency is how much? The digit is 2 and the frequency is how much? 5. So, the for 2, what is the frequency? 5. Similarly, for 3, this is digit 3. And what is the frequency of this digit? Means how many times 3 is being occurred? 8 times. So, this is the frequency of 3. Similarly, for 5, you can see 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, frequency of 5 is how much? 5. After that, 6. Frequency of 6 is how much? 4. Means 6 is repeated how many times? 4 times. Similarly, for 9. This is 8. So, how many times 9 has occurred? 8 times. And for 1, it is given frequency is how much? 5. So, the answer here is 5. So, whenever you are given with this type of question, first prepare the frequency table, and because with the help of the frequency table, it becomes easy to find out the questions with the, and their answers. Okay? So, in this we prepare the frequency table and answer the following question. Number 5, I am not writing, it is fill in the blanks only. What is given? The difference between the maximum and minimum observation is called the, I told you, the difference between the maximum and the minimum. You have to find out difference between the maximum and the minimum of is called observation is called what the it is called the range of the data. Okay. Now the number of observation in a particular class interval is called dash of the class interval. What is that? Number of observation in a particular class interval. Number of observation in a particular class interval is called the frequency of the class interval. The range of the data, it is given to you 15, 13, 14, 17, 19, 16, 14, 15. How you find out the range? How you will find out the range? See, 13 is 1 and 14 is 1. So, 1 plus 1, 2. 17 is 1, so 3. 19 is 1, so 4. 16 is 1, 5. 14 is repeated 2 times here. So, when you will calculate, suppose like it is given to you 15, 13, 14, 17, 19, 16, 14 and 15. How you find out the range here? As we have studied the what is range? We have find out range is that from the highest if we subtract the lowest one. So we get the range. So highest here is how much? 19 and the lowest here is how much? 13. So 19 minus 13 is how much? 6. So 6 is the range in the fill in the blanks. See in question number 6 it is given fill in the blanks. We are given with the weights in kg and you have to find out the class interval. So first weight is given to you as 10 to 20. You have to find out the class mark here. So how you find out the class mark? Sum of the number, lower and upper divided by the 2. So how you find out this is 30 by 2. So what is the class mark for 10 to 20? That is 15. Similarly for 20 to 60 or 20 to 30 how you know 20 plus 30 divided by 2. So this will be 50 by 2. Okay. So this will be 24. So this for 20 to 30 this will be how much? Class mark will be 25. Similarly find out the rest. Now see question number 7 you are given with. For each set of data, make a tally table using the groupings arrange and complete the frequency column. First, you have to make groupings and with the help of the groups, you have to prepare the frequency distribution table. So, what is given in the first portion? The number of tomato picked from tomato plants. Okay, so number of tomatoes is given and suggested group is given to you as 0 to 4, 5 to 9, 10 to 14, 15 to 19. From here you can see, here it is having a gap of 4, here also 4, here also 4, and here also 4. So the next observation will be from 20 to 24, and after 24 to 24 you will get 25 to 28. So here you got the number of observation. With the number of observation, write down 0 to 4, then prepare one tally table. After preparing the tally table, prepare the frequency table. So similarly, 0 to 4, 5 to 9, 10 to 14, and the rest you will have to find out. Find out the next portion also here. Okay, question number 8 here, it is given, the following are the monthly rent in rupees of 30 shops. 30 shops are there, and what monthly rent they are paying? The rents are given in rupees. Okay, using the class interval of each within which one class having interval between 40 to 50. Okay, and you have to exclude 50 here. So 30 to 40 here it is given range. 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70, 70 to 80, and 80 to 90. Okay. Construct the frequency table of the above data. So between 30 to 40, how many shops they are paying rent? Okay, you have to prepare the tally marks, and with the help of the tally marks, prepare the frequency table. Similarly, between 40 to 50, how many shops are paying rupees between 40 to 50? You have to prepare the tally marks and then frequency table. Similarly for the all, and only in this question you are saying, it is said this to construct the frequency table, and it's very easy. Prepare the class interval, tally marks, and from the tally marks you can prepare the frequency, and then this way you can prepare the frequency distribution table. Number 10 given to you. In the following list shows the weight in kg of 22 boys student in a class. Okay, so the list is given of 22 boys whose weights are 37.48, 61.93. These weights are given of 22 boys of a class. Okay, so what it is given, since observation are like 37.48, 62.25, do not fit any intervals. You cannot write 30 from 32.5 or 32.2 to 32.5, like this you cannot write down. Or you cannot write down like 30.2 to 35.2. So this type of interval doesn't exist. So here it is saying, do not fit in any intervals. The class interval have to overlap in such a way that all values fit in. You have to fit such a intervals, take such a intervals in which all the values it got fit. So you have to take the interval between 35 to 40. So as I have taken 40 to 45, 45 to 50, 50 to 55. So in this way you have to take the interval, and suppose it is given 37.48. Okay, so 37, then this will fall between 35 to 40. So 37.48 will fall between 35 to 40 means one tally mark you have to do. Similarly, the rest you put down, write down the tally marks, and prepare the frequency distribution table. So in this way, we finish this chapter, statistics. So before solving this exercise, I suggest you to solve the questions. First solve the example question, because while you solve the example question, solving exercise become easy for you. So first go through the basic points, like what is frequency, what is class interval, what is class mark, what is class size. Prepare the note first, and then go through the examples of this exercise, and then solve this exercise. After completing, you have to solve the SAT portion book also and worksheets also. So thank you for today. Have a nice day.